love they make me shamanya. I'm a little baby marama. Even when my brain just dey tanana. Only you baby lying in my corner.
Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Osomujie-paul, Divine Favor. Thank you for joining me again once again. If you're new here, please join the family by subscribing below and also turn on the post notification button so that whenever I post a video, you get notified. And if you've been here with me, if you're a family, if you're already subscribed, thank you for still joining me once again. Sending you lots of love from this end. So without any further ado, babies, let's get right into the video. So guys, for some weeks now, I've been asking you guys, posting on my IG, posting on my WhatsApp, and asking every one of you to drop questions for me that you would like me to answer on my channel. And I know it took a lot of time because this has been, let's say, last month, but because of my busy schedule, I've been so busy, I have a very tight schedule. But finally, here I am bringing you the video, and I'm gonna try my best to answer all the questions. Because I'm recording with my phone, I wrote down the questions in this my. I know all of you, if you are being part of this family, you guys know this book. This is my book where everything I do is documented. I know, right? So people, without wasting much time, we're going to get right into it, and I'm going to read out your questions and then I'm going to answer them. Okay, the first question is, what made you start vlogging? Okay, basically the major reason why I started vlogging is because I could talk and I like to talk. Like, I can talk here. No, basically that's like the main reason why I stay vlogging. You guys can check out my interview on Women of Freebies blog. You guys get my interview and read some stuff about me personally. But the main reason why I stay vlogging, why I stay YouTube, was because I loved to talk. Like, you know, when they tell people, what's your talent? What's your talent? I do not have talent though. Like, that's like this basic thing. I've checked, there's nothing. They'll say, you, and if you ask people first and they want to, like, you know, take you through that journey of knowing what you like and everything, or helping you discover yourself rather, they always ask you, what do you like? What do you like doing? What do you do effortlessly? What that thing that you do, that when you're doing that thing, you know, those questions, if you are conversant with it. And my brother, my sister, nothing. I don't like doing anything. And the only thing, and I talk a lot, and I don't like doing anything basically. So, and I like talking. So I was like, probably, what if this talking thing is my talent? What if God wants me to use my talking to do something? So basically, that's why I started vlogging. That's why I started my podcast, because I love talking. I love talking. I can't, when they're not putting food in the mouth, my brothers, I can talk for Africa. So I'm like, instead of using this talking to me, talking everywhere, why don't I use it to put it in something productive? Why don't I use it to do something better for myself? And then that was it. And then I started vlogging. Second question. Okay, it was the same person asked, and have you been able to impact lives with it? Yes, I have been able to impact lives with it. You know, when I started my YouTube channel, yeah, I started with a 7-day series. That was in December, from the 1st of December to 7th of December, where I was doing a relationship series and everything. Those my relationship series got a lot of reviews and everything. And people, I knew that they were in those series. I really did some communicate about a lot of things that people take for granted in relationships. So yes, that series on its own impacted people. There was time also I got a request to do a video about how to balance academics, relationship, and every other thing. And I also did that. That video too inspired and impacted lives. And also, when we talk about impact, okay, I stay in my YouTube channel. Like, I've always wanted to do YouTube since, I don't even know when. It's been so long where I had the desire to do YouTube. But then, you know, I was thinking maybe I needed a camera, I needed I needed that to start. Until I talked to someone who told me that you have to start with what you have and everything and everything. So I started YouTube. Then nobody around me knew what was YouTube and all those kind of things. And then I started YouTube. And I started YouTube last year. And this year, guess what? My juniors started into YouTube too. They are also doing YouTube. Check them out, Mwe Twins. they're also doing YouTube, and their friends, as they say, YouTube too, and they are growing fast. Their friends too from school. These are people in SS Trio. They too, they're doing YouTube. Do you get? So I, with this, I know I'm impacting lives, and these are people that I can account for. Like, these are people I know. What about people I do not know? So yeah, I've actually made impact with my YouTube channel. Then the third question, since when did you decide to do all, okay, the YouTube stuff? Did you plan it or did you just roll that way? Actually, it's both planned and unplanned. Right from time, like I said earlier, I've always wanted to do YouTube. I've always wanted to go into the whole YouTube community and everything, right from time. But then I was waiting, like I said, I was waiting for the perfect everything, until someone told me that start from where you are, with that you can be growing, something about lots of others, you know, the advice, what kind of advice and everything. And when that's like in the planning part though, but if in the did it just rolling part, in that part, one day in December, one day in November, around November end, I think that November 30th or something. 30 days of September, I think it's 30th of November. I was sick. I just woke up, did makeup. Someone that is down with malaria. I stayed. That day, I did all the video for the 7 days. I would do. You guys can still check the videos. They are down below. So it just came that way. I just was just down and I just said, okay, let me do this thing. Okay, this question is kind of tactic. You know, I said I wasn't going to sit down to like try and calculate the answers for the questions before I come, so that I will know it's not as I'm preparing. So all these questions are just the way as I'm reading it, that's how I'm seeing it. Wow. How can one aspire to be a doctor? Okay, sorry. How can one aspiring to be a doctor follow his dreams when his parents doesn't want him to be? I think what this person is trying to ask is, how can somebody who wants to be a doctor, like, you know, when he wants to be a doctor, and maybe I think his parents are not in support of him becoming a doctor and everything. See, let me tell you, but the African society, African home, it's not easy, gone. People that have it easy, it's good for them, but it's not really easy. You know, when you have all these kind of parents that they want you to do what they want you to do, and you don't have a say to it and everything. But what I believe is this: before your parents can allow you to do some certain things and take some certain decisions, you have to first show them that you are matured enough to take those decisions. You have to let them know that, okay, you know what you want to do and everything. You cannot be somebody now that maybe science subjects, maybe you don't need to pass very well in your physics, you don't need to pass very well in your chemistry, secondary school. You don't have to study, now want to be a doctor. And your parents know, say you used to get D in chemistry, physics, mathematics, all these subjects. They not come out and tell you want to be a doctor. They will take you as a joker. But if you're serious, they are seeing it. You know, they say when you're great to be straight A, straight everything, straight A, you don't even need to convince them. They will know, this is my picking. Doctor. And in this our Nigeria, that parents say, want their children to do the medicine. How come now you don't want to do medicine? Your parents don't want to agree. Well, I think you have to sit them down and talk to them. See, everything is all about communication. Sometimes parents, they feel like, this might be kidding us. You know, get sense. You don't know what you want to do and everything. May we decide for them, because you know, that small picking, they worry them. But there's a way you sit down, sit your parents down, and tell them, daddy, this is what I want to do. Mommy, this is what I want to do. And this, and tell them your reasons why you want to do this, and give them some promises. Okay, if I do this, I promise you that I'm going to excel in it. Just give me a chance to question for the next question. Okay. How do you manage all you do effectively with school and all? Okay, to be very, very sincere, being a student and being a YouTuber is very, very stressful. Being a student and being a YouTuber is very, very stressful. It's stressful, especially as concerning the course I'm doing. When you want to be cramming cases, and you don't want to be doing YouTube, like, they follow, they don't even relate. They don't relate, you get, they don't follow. So it's crazy. It's really difficult. It takes a lot for you to balance schooling and YouTube. In fact, balance schooling and anything. Do you get? It takes a lot for you to balance schooling and anything whatsoever. But this is how I balance my own. I don't even know if I'm balancing it. Truth be told, I don't know if I'm managing it effectively. But this is just what I do. You need to set priorities. Even in that my relationship, how to balance relationship, I said it. You need to set your priorities, yeah? You need to know what comes first and what comes second. On my list right now. Okay, well, in COVID-19. No school again. The same one not go school. But like if it was in school section, academics comes first before YouTube. You get? So I know I'm spending maybe 70% of my time in academic. If that's not even possible. How do I know book? Do I know book like that? The thing is this, okay. Let's say I've taken their lights, but this video has to continue. You know why? Because I've been postponing and postponing and postponing this video. And now that I had the chance to do it, like a serene environment and everything, NEPA had to show that they are who they are. Regardless of their mishap, this video must continue. So we just have to make do with what we have to make do, guys. So, Kai, I'm sad, people. Okay, to the question. I was saying you put your priorities, set your priorities right. Know what you're going to do first. And as school comes first, then YouTube. So the majority of the time you spend doing your schoolwork, everything. Then the little time, you can use it to just create. And we say, sometimes you just, most times, especially for me. Sometimes it seems like it's take our time, if it's play, all these people, play things. If you are actually serious, if you are very good with your time management, you can actually just know how to balance academics and balance everything. Because all those times I used to do all those small things, you are writing stuff of what you want to say on YouTube channel and doing all those things, working hard and all. Then my motivation. I don't know. This is my motivation, though. It may not be the same for you. And it's not like I'm not the kind of person that, okay, this person is always motivating me, or that person is what's motivating me. My motivation. The reason why I'm doing what I do, the reason why I am trying my best, the reason why I know, okay, yes, I know I have talent now, let me do one thing, is because it's because I want to be relevant to my people, this life. If you know, get, nobody go know you. If you get, people go know you. The point of the whole story is this. I want to be relevant. I want to be relevant to myself. I want to be relevant to my society. I want to make impact. I don't want to be anybody. I don't want to just be that person. I want to be someone of excellence. Someone that people look up to. Someone that, okay, they say the youths look up to. That's just what I want to be. I want to be someone that my name, when they say divine people, everybody will know who they are talking about. Like when you say Otelola, we know that this is Otelola. We're not talking about Otelola in one place. We know who we're talking about. So I want to be financially independent. I want to be simple. The plans for my life. I just want to just live a chilled life. I want to live a cruising and a chilling life. I want to just stay relevant. I want to be able to impact. And that's just it. I don't want suffer, all those kind of things. That's why I'm trying my best to do something. Even when it's not looking like as if things are going well, I just want to just impact. I want to do something. My motivation is myself. It's seeing that if I sleep, just maybe I could just be that regular anybody. No, I'm not regular. I'm extraordinary and I just need to do what I have to do to be where I want to be. So, how do you stay relevant? How do I stay relevant? By doing what I'm doing. I stay relevant by going to school. I stay relevant by doing my YouTube. I stay relevant by doing my podcast. I still remember by selling my lashes, posting them. Sometimes, maybe customer is not coming, but me posting it. Okay, relevant. So that's just in. I still remember by just doing the little things I can do within my space and my environment. Okay, when you don't feel the support you expect, how do you react? Okay, when I don't feel the support that I expect from people, you know, there's sometimes, but YouTube, sir, it's harder than it is, especially when you are growing. There's a way YouTube is. Sometimes you expect that, okay, this particular video I'm about to push out right now, it's going to get me lots of views and everything, lots of subscribers. And that video that you are about to put out is something that you have wasted energy, time, and everything on. And you put it, and after a day, you're seeing just so views or something. Really, sometimes it's discouraging. But then, what I do when I don't get what I expect, I just tell myself that life, see, this is a process. Life is a process. Everything is in stages. Life is in stages. It's a process. I may be here today. I know that with time I'm growing. And the thing about process is that you are not always in one level. You are growing. Whether you know it or you do not know it, you are growing. You are evolving. You get. So, even if I don't get that, what I expect, even if I don't get that results that I expect, I'm like, okay, it's a process. Tomorrow is going to be better. Better days are ahead. That's just it. Better days are ahead. Tomorrow is going to be better. That's just my motivation. That's everything. That's it's nice to encourage myself. However, I've been trolled. Surprisingly, no. You know, somehow when I started doing YouTuber, I was expecting people to come and troll me. Like, come to my page. Although most of the people that know me now, that was like. But then, I was expecting like people to come and troll me and all those kind of things. But nobody has trolled me ever. Nobody has ever trolled me. And that's good. It's just that my positive energy that I'm exuding. Coming around, you know what I want to say. Now, who all puts me for box? Okay, next question is it Messi or Tacha? Messi or Tacha? See, the thing is this, I'm not with Messi, Tacha, Messi, and Tacha. Both of them are amazing people, and I root for the both of them. Both of them are doing great things in their separate fields. Those of them are emerging. They are the kind of women that you need to look up to because they are struggling. It goes beyond just, okay, yes, they went for a show that made them popular. Okay. But you know, you could be popular after a show and sit down and do nothing. But you see that these women are day in, day out, working hard, day in, day out, putting out new stuff, day in, day out, staying relevant. So there are people that we should emulate. I root for the both of them. I love Messi. I love Tacha. I love Tacha. I love Messi. They are both amazing females. Next question. Introverts or extroverts? I would like to put myself in okay, I'm an extrovert. Yeah, I'm an extrovert. I'm an extrovert. I'm a really boisterous and loud person. I'm an extrovert. But I feel like if I'm in a place I'm not comfortable, you're gonna see my introvert in me. If I don't know how to put it. There's sometimes I'm not comfortable in a space. I just go to myself in my own shell and do my own stuff. But majority of the time, I'm an extrovert. Vanilla or chocolate? Vanilla all day. Like, I don't know, but I like vanilla. I don't know the whole chocolate. Even strawberry, I don't like strawberry. I don't like chocolate. I don't like anything. I prefer vanilla all day. Why would I be in a relationship? Like, what was that thing that would make me be? Like, I'm kind of pissed about that. I do not believe that relationship is just something you just do for fun, catch cruise. No. I'm not that kind of person. I am, when it comes to, even if I may not be so serious about all that part of my life, when it comes to relationship, I'm very serious about it. I don't need that relationship to catch cruise. I don't need that relationship to catch for fun. There will be fun. All those things come with it. But that's not like the major reason. I feel like relationships are things that people should enter when they are ready, one. And secondly, when they know that, when they are to achieve purpose. Relationship is to achieve purpose. You cannot just be in a relationship to catch. No, it's because we know that we're going to achieve purpose. Because now, okay, me and you together, if I bring what I have, when I mean have, I don't mean finance, but if I bring what I have, like what's inside of me, what God has placed inside of me, and you bring what God has placed inside of you, and we merge it together, we will do exploits. That's the only reason why I'm entering into a relationship. Because I know that you bring, I bring, and we do great things. And I feel that's what God wants. And that's why the issue of marriage was even brought about in the first place. I hope I've been able to answer your question and to convince. Let me say I do debate. I did debate in second. Do not try me. I hope I've been able to convince and not convince you that. Convince. I said convince and convince. I hope. I hope I've been able to convince and not confuse you that I will be in a relationship because I want to achieve purpose. Thank you. And with that, guys, we've come to the end of this video. You know what you do. If you enjoyed watching this video, please and please subscribe below. Subscribe below. And you know what? Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe below. Share. Share to your friends. Some of people don't share videos. That's just a lot. If you like what I do, if you support what I do here, you should be able to, you know, help my ministry by sharing my videos, by subscribing. If you are watching my video and you are laughing and or you are just like, okay, getting one or two things from inside from the video, do well to subscribe. Subscribing, you don't need to pay. Just subscribe. Help my ministry. Help me grow. Help me grow. So I love you all. This is dear Osomujie-paul. Sign out now.
I'm coming.